By the cover art, it's gonna be a fucking fun time. In the previous episodes, we got in a lot of fights, killed a bit of people, and hopefully this episode is just as entertaining as episode 2 was, because I really enjoyed episode 2. I didn't really enjoy episode 1 though.
Sure, there's no trouble. Lord White will install a garrison of 20 men. Should they be all right? You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure Ironwood from House Forester. Lady Marjorie might not favor upon such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although, what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you. And your house.
Father,
I'm going to kill you. Is that so?
I'm glad I found you, my boy. It's been far too long.
Who the fuck is he?
My uncle.
Roderick? Roderick!
For gods, it is you!
Sir?
Fetch the maester! Hurry!
Fetch the maester!
Let him go!
I don't regret this decision at all.
You kill me, and the Lost Legion won't stop until you and your friend are dead.
Yeah, I'd say, but I didn't say finish it off, though. I mean,
we're 100 miles from Yunkai. We're never going to give up.
Never. There's still war about Tazan.
Yes, well, perhaps you shouldn't have snapped his neck.
I don't care.
There is such
care.
A thing as overdoing.
He was gutter trash, and I bloody felt like it. That neck was begging to get stopped.
You've grown older, but you haven't grown up.
It's only a matter of time before they overtake us.
Can we double back?
Not without meeting our mates from Yunkai. We're well and truly fucked this time, Asha.
during severe winters when the Skahazadan floods.
Also, FYI,
what?
That red curtain is not the shower curtain. That's supposed to be tucked out when you take a shower.
I know.
Why is it soaking wet all
the time? I don't know. Wall, maybe.
What do you think? Could we climb out of here?
Pretty steep, Basher.
We'd be totally exposed if your friends arrived before we reached the top.
I know, but unless they have crossbows, we're fine. Some on the ground, maybe?
Within seven.
These rocks, I already looked at.
We can dig our way through. We'll try to scramble over.
I don't know. Either will be slow or tricky. One wrong move and the whole thing will collapse on us.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do now. Do you want me to talk to you again?
The rock slide looks recent.
Well, you see, Beska came back. She risked her life for us. Trust her now.
This may sound fine. Beska's immaterial. I have to put you first. You are all that matters to me, Asher.
Beska matters to me. How do you know all that? About the floods and the caves?
I've read all about Essos on the voyage over. Histories of marine, histories of Slaver's Bay.
Let me know if you find anything. To say thank you. I realize this isn't your fight. That marine is the last place you want to go.
God, Sasha, don't go soft on me. Together till we're dead.
You know anything else about these bastards hunting us?
Well, obviously they hate you.
Thanks. I figured that out on my own.
You've heard the rumor, right? They carve their faces as an initiation. Flaying the skin right off. Looks like they're inside out. That's why they wear those helmets.
pretty fucked up.
That's a load of horse shit. Mesker, did you see anything?
Well, I looked at everything, good. Unless something popped up, I haven't seen it yet. Watch this be something important.
Looks like we're not alone.
No obvious wounds. Maybe he died of thirst.
Listen.
That's water.
I hear water
from underground. There might be a cave nearby.
Look at this. Gold.
Fat lot of good it did him.
That's a nice purse of gold. I wonder who he was carrying that kind of money out here.
Well, grab
Let's
it.
Let's not worry about that now. We need to find cover.
But we need to grab it.
He's not going to need that.
Asher, the Lost Legion will be here at any moment.
This is Essos. There's always time for gold. Oh, shit. It's them.
Well, don't stand there.
Monte Prado!
Fuck, they have crossbows.
Come on!
Go! They're behind us. Damn it!
Find us another way out of here.
Well, we're pretty good, actually, if that's their only entrance. You just keep stabbing them.
There's a light!
They won't come through.
See if there's a way through.
We'll hold them off.
Yes, let's walk. Oh, pretty big tooth. Is there a monster in the cave? Holy fuck, there is. Oh my god, dude. Is that a dragon? That's fucking dope, dude.
Easy.
Fuck that. You can't fight a dragon, dude. Not even a waste of time. Really? We're gonna hit it now? See, I told you. I knew that would happen. That's why I didn't want to fight him. This one was fine. Stop standing and run, dude. I don't know what to do here. Save them, I guess. I don't even have a weapon, so how was I supposed to help her with the drill?
Mesker! Can you walk, Asher? We have to move, now!
I'm fine. You think I don't know pain? Get out of
here. Hurry! The beast is coming around!
Thank you.
god, the fucking dragon! Holy shit, dude. Wow. That's pretty cool. I didn't know a dragon would pop up in this game. Well, they started off episode 3 pretty nicely, too. It seems like whenever they start off the game with Asher, you know the shit's gonna start pretty good. The past two episodes, it started out with Asher. Or I should say the past episode and this episode.
You two sons of whores looking thick as thieves. Having a good laugh over nicking my knife, eh, Garrett? Men like you turn traitor for nothing. It's in your blood. Next, you'll be killing men of the watch for a loaf of bread.
Look, Finn, I didn't mean for it to get out of hand like that.
And I didn't mean to end up in this shithole living with backstabbing assholes. You'll always be an asshole, Garrett. But just a fucking craven.
Look, it's over, all right. Just drop it.
You can bugger off if you like.
Finn, leave him alone. It wasn't Garrett's fault. If you're gonna hate someone, hate me.
With pleasure.
Now, it doesn't matter what the world once called you. After today, you're all brothers. Could even be that the man standing next to you saves your life one day. Maybe you'll save his. Let's find out then, shall we? Casper, to the builders. Finn, to the rangers. Eric, to the stewards. You, to the rangers. Cotter, to the builders. And finally, Garrett, to the rangers. That's it. May all the gods preserve you.
Well, there we are.
I'll be patching up the wall. You'll be defending it.
Should you northern boys want your gods to give a blessing to this union, there's a weirwood tree beyond the wall. Now form up. Follow my lead.
Didn't he already tell us to go to the rangers?
Sooner see me bloodied in the yard than offer a hand.
Shows you what kind of right fools are running this place. I can't believe they made you a ranger. You're fit for the job.
Like it or not, we're brothers now. Means we're gonna have to get along.
Don't count on it. You wouldn't even be here if you didn't have Snow leading you by the hand the whole way.
I'd keep an eye out for you if you weren't such an arse about everything.
You don't give a shit about me. No one around here gives a shit about me. They wouldn't even care if I... Do you know how many rangers I've never heard from again in these parts? And I'm about to become one myself. All alone out here. Wildlings everywhere. Or wolves. Oh, God. Giant wolves.
It's all right to be afraid. Keeps you alert, keeps you from being too confident. Like the next time we fight. I'll remember how hard it was to put you down.
I suppose you're right.
You want a different assignment? Because I hear they need someone to clean the shit house.
See, that's why I got so fucking mad at you, Garrett. You're the closest thing I have to a friend.
You handled that well, Garrett. They say the old gods watch us through the weirdness. Gods are not forgiving. We brothers have to be.
Nice. I didn't fuck it up. Nice. Alright, nice.
We're here. After this, there's no... Now go.
Of the old gods, the Night's Watch offers you a place beside us. Now save words for all to hear and embrace us as your own.
What the? Yo, that tree's got a face.
Hear my words. Bear witness to my vow.
Oh. I wonder if they put body in there. Hear my words and bear witness to my vow. Night gathers, it shall not end until my death. What is this? I can't move.
Hold no lands.
Hear my word, bear witness.
I shall wear no crowns and win no glory. I shall live and die my post. I am the sword of the darkness. I am the watcher on the walls.
Oh,
I am the shield.
Really? These guys don't get to. Wow.
And honor to the Night's Watch for this night and all the nights to come.
You knelt as boys. Rise now as men of the Night's Watch.
Welcome to your new family, Garrett.
Kind of depressing a little bit.
We're men of the watch now. Means we get to piss off the wall whenever we want.
No, you needed an excuse to play with yourself, Finn.
Garrett, you've got a visitor. Over there.
Who is it?
Do I look like your fucking squire?
Don't forget the practice shorts.
Uncle Duncan!
Garrett!
It's good to see you. They told me you were at the Weirwood Tree.
I've missed you. Never expected to see you here.
I've business with the Night's Watch. A delivery of ironwood shields. Keep you all out of harm's way.
It looks like Duncan. It is.
Right, the delivery looks in order.
The gods do miracles. You look well, nephew. I'm told you're a ranger now. That's good.
Uncle?
Things aren't going well at Iron Mouth, Garrett.
I know. I heard the news about Ethan.
I wasn't there when it happened. Small mercy, I suppose. Not having to see our lord struck down with such barbarity.
But House Forrester is nothing if not resilient.
Our house has survived for centuries.
I should have been there protecting Ethan. What good am I at the wall?
That's why I'm really here. Do you recall Lord Forrester's last words to you? Just before he died, Gregor's final command, spoken to you in confidence.
He said the North Grove must never be lost.
Indeed. But first, it must be found. I've been reading his journals, scouring the legends for any clue what Lord Forrester knew. I think I've found the answer. He describes a fortification, a protected citadel of sorts, hidden from the world, one filled with great power. It was scattered among his notes. Almost an obsession, a vital secret he protected at all costs.
And you think it's north of the wall?
His notes suggest as much. And you must find it, Garrett. The search won't be easy. But you're a Tuttle. Our lord knew you wouldn't fail him.
Somewhere north of the wall. That's not a lot to go on, Uncle. How am I supposed to find it?
The first chance you get to head north, take it.
And then?
You leave the Night's Watch behind. Strike out on your own. This is no small request I make. I know that. But there's no other choice.
Uncle, that's desertion. The Night's Watch execute men who desert.
I know. I wouldn't ask this of you if there was another way. This will help guide you. I found it hidden in Lord Forrester's.
I just became one.
What is that?
Page from our lord's journal. The one he tore out and kept separate. Why? I don't know.
It's a map. To the North Grove.
Aye.
You said it was a citadel of some kind. Could this be it? No. It couldn't be that easy. It's hidden here somewhere. I used to be frightened of weirwood trees. Before I was a man grown, I swear, I actually could hear him whispering sometimes. This looks familiar.
What is it, Garrett?
Talia gave me this. Before I left.
Oh. Wait. Lord Forrester gave Ethan a similar one as well. Roderick too. I wonder.
This map's only missing pumpkins and snarks. This can't be real, Uncle. Bloody ice tracker. It's got to be good. Now that I would love to see. Hear the werewoods whisper.
Look. There's a clasp. It must open.
I had no idea this was inside. Another werewood.
But why?
Maybe it's a key. To solve in the map. telling us where to look on the map.
Rotate right, yeah.
Doesn't look right. Maybe try another. Wait a second. Rotate it back.
Bearwood's mouth.
Uncle, no.
Whatever this place is, the North Grove must be near.
There's only one way to find out. Here, take this map. Everything we hold dear may well depend on your success. It's a lot to put on our shoulders. The lives of a whole house.
I'll try, Uncle. It's no small task. I'm still just a squire.
I know what I'm asking of you, and I know you're up to the challenge. God's watch over you. You're the son I never had.
Let's go, Gary.
I don't know. Probably like little shards or something.
Quite so.
Rather mysterious. A stranger arrives and you're chatting him up. Someone said it was your uncle looking for you. Well, what did he want?
Looked like you two had a lot to talk about.
Must have been important to come to Castle Black.
He's castellan to House Forrester. They sell ironwood to the builders.
So you were just talking about lumber all that time?
It looked like he gave you something.
It was nothing. Let's go and celebrate.
Already keeping secrets from your brothers, eh?
Garrett's right. The wall's gonna melt before we get up there. Come on.
There are so many guests already arriving. And have you seen the wedding decorations they put up in the gardens? So beautiful. You know, we're as lucky as she is. Marjorie was but a lady when we were sent to serve at Highgarden. But in just a few days' time, we'll be attending to a queen at a royal feast. Where we're standing, we'll be able to see everyone. And everyone will be able to see us. We've certainly come a long way, haven't we? I've been meaning to say what I told you about my family.
Wait.
It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust. Sarah, you should be careful who you trust all day. Secrets can be dangerous in the wrong hands. I'll certainly be more careful in the future. Hold on, look. There he is. Lord Morgrim? No. Next to him, Lord Tarn. And this wedding may be the best chance of meeting a husband I'll ever have. I have to go talk to him. Marjorie won't notice it for a few minutes longer. Could you make an excuse for me? Please. I'm not asking for it. Are you sure you know what you're doing, Sarah? Marjorie's so busy. I can't just wait for her to find a match for me. Please, just don't tell Marjorie.
What are you doing here?
No, I shouldn't be here.
I don't know what might have happened if you hadn't helped me.
I could say the same to you, Lady Mira. But I came here to warn you. I was down at Fleetwood last night, and I overheard a couple of Lannister guards talking about... They already know he's missing. Probably dead. They're questioning people. Searching for his body.
Who are they questioning? Do they know about me?
I don't think so. They have no reason to. Anyway, he'll never show up again to tell them. No one will know what you did. What? What is it? If we're gonna survive this, there can't be any details we've overlooked.
Someone paid him to kill me. They're still out there. They might try again.
Oh, God. You need to keep your head down. Stay out of sight for a while.
How? Do you forget who I serve?
Just keep your eyes open. And I'll watch your back. We're in this together now.
Why are you helping me?
What do you mean? I'm a friend, Lady Mira. My name's Tom. We help each other. Or it's both our heads.
What were you even doing there tonight?
I once told you. There are people who'd be willing to help you. People who want you alive. I'm here to make sure that happens.
Wait,
what?
You mean someone... Mira.
My lady.
Really? A tryst in the bushes with that coal boy. Not to say it's wrong. All the lords and knights in King's Landing. Truly, it's nothing, Sarah. He's a friend. Really? Is that so? Come on. Margaery expects us at the throne room. We don't want to be late. You can tell me all about this Lord Tarwick on the way. Well, if you really want to know. First of all, his name's Garibald, and he has this really funny accent. He told me the cleverest story.
I've given the musicians a list of songs to play for Joffrey at the feast. I assume
you
have no problems with the reigns of Castamere. I trust you've chosen all the standards.
Just clicked just right there. I think she's trying to kill me. I think she's the one.
Your Grace, my lady.
Which reminds me, Joffrey will require his King's Guard close at hand during the feast.
That's why she's never there. She's never around me when some dude tries to kill you. And she's always got this kind of weird stare at you.
Is that what I heard? If you're going to speak out of turn, girl, you should finish what you start.
Sarah's simply in awe of your presence. Your Grace, we're happy to spend the feast wherever it pleases you.
Your happiness is not my concern.
Maybe it's her.
I asked your handmaiden here at the Iron Throne whom she would serve if forced to choose between yourself and the king. She was deferential to the crown then, as she is now. Words are wind. In any case, it's settled. The King's Guard will stay with Joffrey. Your handmaidens will sit elsewhere.
Of course, Your Grace. Anything for my beloved Joffrey.
Fuck you.
Lady Margaery, we may not see eye to eye on everything, but I hope you will at least agree with me that our handmaidens should know their place. And that place is not with my brother, Tyrion.
What did she mean by that? You and Tyrion? What you do reflects on me. If something's going on, I need to know about it.
We only shed some wine, my lady.
Drinking wine with Tyrion Lannister. Sarah, what do you know of this?
Tyrion approached us, my lady. It was his idea, not Mira's.
I don't care what your intentions were, Mira. You went to a Lannister.
Didn't I, like, kiss your ass in the first episode? Now you're being a bitch to me.
I've never tried to help you. Why are you making trouble for me?
It was just a cup of wine. Nothing more.
I don't have the time or patience for your games, Mira. Right now, I need you both to be my handmaidens, and that's all I need you to be. Let there be no mistake. If I hear of you speaking so much as a word to Tyrion Lannister again, you can go home to your family.
I'm only trying to help my family. You would do the same for yours. Please don't send me home.
This can't happen again.
Fuck you.
Roderick, it's the White Gills. They're assembling in the courtyard. They've woken the house. You can't let this go on. They want to see us cower.
I'll need my sentinel. Go ahead, Talia, and have Roiland meet me in the courtyard.
Little fucking pricks trying to start trouble.
Swinging your foot around, lording it over my family. Now look at you, hey? Roderick the Ruined.
What are they doing?
But the name fits, don't it?
Make no mistake. I'm still the Lord of Iron, and I run this house.
That sounds like the old Roderick, beating his chest every chance he got. I don't think he gets it. Your brother Ethan didn't get it either.
You bite your tongue.
I am in charge now. And the first thing you need to know is that if I am
not happy, no one is happy.
So my men are taking
Fucking, they really want us to suck their dick, don't they?
From now on.
What? You can't.
You'll have to go through me. I won't have my men sleeping out in your barn in shit and filth.
I don't care if you're happy. I'll be caught to where I tell you.
I wasn't fucking asking, Roderick. And what's more, you will treat my men right. I've heard what you've done, and if they're eating wormy bread, then your people better be eating shit off the ground. I'm not here to keep them in line. I'm here to keep you in line.
If your men don't like it here, you can march them back to High Point.
Watch yourself, Roderick.
This is against the King's law. You've no right to make such demands.
I have every right. We're here under the orders of Bruce Bolton. Warden of the North. So I will be in your halls. I will be in your courtyard. I will sit on your
fucking
castle and be in your bedchambers if I bloody won't please.
You can't do this, bastard. You can't just do what
I'm mad. This is my house. You will do as I say.
Why should I listen to some cripple with half a face?
Now, me and my men will take our place in your hall.
Unless you think you and your army stop me. No, you know better than that. You know where we'll be.
This is outrageous. You can't go in there.
We can and we will.
Unless you want this all to end right now, eh? I'm the only lord here.
Come on.
Right.
Do
wise.
Why the fuck should I listen to you?
Parading in here like a conquering fucking...
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof, soiling our house.
I know you tried to stop them, but we can only take this occupation for so long. Our people will break. And the way Grip Whitehill came in,
whether he rides out on horseback,
do something. What the fuck? Are you just gonna stand there and watch?
Very good.
Wow.
But Grip Whitehill isn't the beginning of our troubles, or the end of them. We need to look at all the pieces. Whitehill men aren't just in our house. They raided our lands, burnt farms, and cut down our trees. All the way from here to High Point.
How do we kill a snake, then? By smashing its head.
Griff is in the head. It's his father.
Perhaps. But Griff is here. We have access to him.
And they have Ryan. He carved these soldiers himself. I don't care what Gwyn Whitehill may have told you at the funeral. Who knows what horrors they're putting him through? Held prisoner at High Point.
To do something.
My lord, at least give us a target to aim for.
Expel Griff, save Ryan.
We can only take this occupation.
Well,
so
see here, now basically we should do this one because saving Ryan, they have Ryan. That's the only reason why any of these people are listening to him.
If
we do this to Griff, these guys over here are gonna get pissed off. They might kill Ryan, or they might even say we'll never get him back. So this would be a different type of choice. Like, be kind of stupid to do that. We can wait it out a little bit. We've already dealt with enough shit. We can wait out their shit, and we can save Ryan. Once we save Ryan, then we can do whatever the fuck we want. We can get him out of here. So yeah, we're going with this one.
Asher means to sail home from Essos.
Yes. I'll be right back.
company of hardened sellswords. But they're not bannermen. We'll need to pay them for it. Which is why Mira's part to play is just as crucial. She can get us the coin we need in King's Landing.
You don't imagine we have the luxury of waiting for them. Asha and Mira are a long way from here.
I have faith in my children.
I don't think Blood Whitehall will kindly stand by while we pull ourselves together.
If we have to go to battle before we're ready, we risk losing everything. Sometimes you have no choice.
That time may indeed come, but it's not now. The White Hills aren't ready.
I gotta be right back. Should've brought my fucking car.
My lord, there may be something we can do now. A voice from Highpoint,
Gwyn Whitehill. I spoke with her a few.
As did I, and she's willing to meet. Away from her father's guards. I may not be your sentinel, but please consider this. You'd be wise to hear what she has to say.
Why would she tell me that? Is it still about Asha?
I couldn't say. That was a long time ago. Even if she still has feelings, it can't be just about that. It's a chance to learn more about our enemies. We need to take it, and I'll make sure no one else knows. For now, at least.
Good.
And if things right with Gwyn, she may even help us in Highpoint when the time comes.
I want the dove pie served with a spoon of lemon cream. We'll have to let the kitchens know. And these flowers. They're just all wrong in the crown, Lance. Mira, are you listening to me?
Lady Marjorie, good tidings to us.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion.
And you, Lady Mira. A word in private, if I may. I'll return her shortly.
Who would I be to deny Lord Tyrion?
Very soon you'll be queen. If you're anything at current, deny me all you like.
Please excuse me for a moment,
I promise I won't keep long. I don't think Lady Marjorie likes me.
What did you want, my lord?
There's much unpleasant business to be done today. I bring you a bit of it. I've arranged for the crown to purchase Forrester Iron. The royal decree sits on my desk, and I'll have my squire Podrick see to it at the first opportunity. You'll bring prosperity to your family.
You honor me, Lord Tyrion. Only you could make such a strong gesture to House Forrester. My lord, do I still owe you a favor?
Is handmaiden to the new queen?
Of course.
Undoubtedly useful. I'm sure I'll think of something. Enjoy the festivities.
Goodbye, Lord Tyrion. Today of all days. You know I didn't want you talking to him. You're playing a dangerous game. Sarah will help me with my gown and hair. I'll deal with you after the wedding. Come with me, Sarah.
Thank you.
Garrett.
Easy now. Sorry. I was just keeping at the ready.
That's good. Don't lose that. I understand your uncle paid you a visit. What did he want?
I think I'm gonna stop it here, guys. I can see that's getting a little laggy already. Yeah, I'm gonna stop it here. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more content. I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace!